Woohoo, Mr. Frog! Are you alive?
Of course I am. Why wouldn't I be, huh?
See that, friends? Mr. Frog can breathe both inside and outside of water.
It is magic, Dr. Binocs. You won't understand. Ha ha ha!
Well, it's no magic, my friends. It's just a way of life for some animals in the animal kingdom. Come, let me tell you something about it. Zoom in! The animal kingdom is divided into two groups, invertebrates and vertebrates. But today, we'll talk about the vertebrates. The animals with a backbone are called vertebrates, which are further split into smaller groups. Amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals. Now, let us explore a little into their worlds. Amphibians. Frogs and salamanders are some of the most popular amphibians. They are the ones that can live both on land and water. They are cold-blooded animals and lay eggs coated in jelly. They have gills to breathe underwater and lungs to breathe on land. Reptiles. Snakes and crocodiles are examples of reptiles. Their bodies are made of dry scales. They lay their eggs on land and spend almost all their time underwater. They too are cold-blooded, and it is only sometimes that they come on land to soak the sun. Birds. Oh, you've all seen birds, haven't you? Owls, sparrows, parrots, etc. Well, they have feathers and wings. But hey, not all birds fly. They lay eggs that are hard-shelled and are warm-blooded. Mammals. Lions and pandas are examples of mammals. They give birth to young ones instead of laying eggs. They have lungs to breathe and are warm-blooded. They have hair or fur and have special glands to produce milk for their young ones. Even humans are mammals. Yes, you are. Trivia time! Animals without a backbone are called invertebrates, and they were the first animals to evolve. There are approximately 52,000 species of vertebrates. So, what are you waiting for? Look around and start identifying. This is me, zooming out. Tune in next time for more fun facts.